Hi guys, Dr. A. So this short series is going to be over some hepatitis serology, and we are going to start with hepatitis A. So hepatitis is an inflammation of the liver that can be caused by either infectious or toxic agents, and it is characterized by jaundice, fever, liver enlargement, and abdominal pain. Now, the markers we're going to look at in this series are all for viral types of hepatitis, which would be an infectious type of hepatitis. On the toxic hepatitis, you can have things like alcoholic hepatitis or hepatitis caused by certain drugs or toxins. The best lab markers for following the course of primary viral hepatitis infections are bilirubin. So the level of bilirubin rises rapidly and then falls slowly, especially if cholestasis, which means poor or blocked bile flow from the liver, is present. ALT, next, it rises abruptly and usually falls without a plateau, and it rises to 100 to 400 international units per liter, and it fluctuates within this range for varying lengths of time. The longer the ALT remains elevated, the more likely that chronic hepatitis will develop. And of all the liver enzymes, ALT is the one that's the most liver specific, so it's the most helpful. And then the viral markers that we are going to be discussing in this series. So for hepatitis A, it is an RNA virus with an incubation period that is 15 to 45 days, with the average being 28 days. The spread of hepatitis A is primarily by fecal-oral route, by contaminated food or contaminated water, or by person-to-person contact. We had an outbreak in our region, and it was tied to restaurants, especially fast food restaurants, and so anything that a worker that has hepatitis A that has not washed their hands is handling, especially something that is not cooked, then that could be tainted with hepatitis A. If you eat there, then you can get hepatitis A. It is responsible for 50% of the acute hepatitis cases in the U.S. It does not have a chronic phase. Hepatitis A doesn't. There are some of the other hepatitis, like hepatitis B, does have a chronic phase. Many patients with type A hepatitis never get clinically ill, which again, this can contribute to the spread of it, because for example, if a fast food worker has it and they don't get clinically ill, then they have hepatitis A and they don't know they have it, and it could be spreading it if they're not using proper hand hygiene. So only 10% of patients become symptomatic, and of these patients, only 10% become jaundiced. And the majority of patients will have full recovery, usually in something like a couple of months. There's a substantial mortality risk in elderly patients, as well as in patients that have chronic hepatitis B or hepatitis C, and in patients with chronic liver disease from other causes. There is now a vaccine that is available. So I know that the generation of my children, so they were born mid to late 90s and early 2000, all of them got the hepatitis A as part of their childhood series, but like my generation did not. So there are a variety of people, the younger ones usually being immunized, but some of the older generations not being immunized. And there are two tests available to measure antibodies to hepatitis A. There's the anti-HAV IgM. So IgM antibodies always rise first in an infection, in any infection. And so this one is more clinically relevant because it shows acute or recent infection. Antibodies are present at the onset of jaundice and will decline within 12 months, but usually within 6 months these decline. And then you can do a total anti-HAV antibody. And so those are all the isotypes of the antibody. So IgM, IgG, all of it. And it can indicate present or previous infection or immunization. So it just shows that you have antibodies to hepatitis A. Again, could be immunization, could be that you had it. Only IgM indicates recent infection. All right, that's it for hepatitis A. Thank you.